Hi and welcome. In this tutorial, we will learn how to run R from Python. To do this, we are going to use the Rpy2 module. This module offers a Python interface to R. Obviously, Rpy2 requires that you have both R and Python installed. When it comes to Python, you can use both version 2.7 or 3.3 or higher. So Rpy2 can be installed using pip. If you are using Anaconda, the scientific Python distribution, you can also install it using conda. Just type conda install crrpy2. Okay. So in this Rpy2 example, in this video, I will show you how to carry out an repeated measures ANOVA using the R packages afex and emmeans. If you are running into the library error where there is a conflict when converting R symbols to Python symbols, you will also find a solution for that towards the end of the video when we import the R package emmeans, that is. So make sure that you watch the entire video and check the description below for useful information and links. And hit the thumbs up button, please. Okay, let's start coding. We're going to import R objects, R packages, and str vectors. So import Rpy2 objects as objects. And import Rpy2 objects packages as R packages. And finally, from Rpy2 objects vectors ors import str vector. And let's run this code. And if we don't have the packages afex and emmeans installed, we can install them also using Python as an interface to R. So package names afex and emmeans. Oops, we need this. So we create a tuple, and if all R packages is installed X for X in package names. So we check if any of the packages in this tuple is installed. So we could have many more inside of that. And we set a Boolean variable to true. And else the have package variable is false. Okay, and if not, have package, oops, we're going to import utils from R. R packages import R utils. And now we're going to choose a cron mirror, so we install install the packages from if needed. So utils choose cron mirror. I'm just going to pick the first one. So pack names to install, we create a list x for x in package name. If not, our packages is installed X. Okay, and if this list pack names to install is larger than zero, we're going to install packages. So here we are going to use a str vector. Pack names to install. So if you were to have one of these installed, this is going to install only one of them. Cool. So the next step is, of course, to have some data to use. And the data objects R. So we're going to just paste some R code in here. You can use R, the R method from the objects. And I'm just going to copy paste here the read table. So we're going to use some data here from a source, online source. And the next step then is to import afex, R packages, import R, afex, and we set up our model. Oh, we can have a look at the data before. So we'll see. Seems like it takes some time, like this. Okay, so we have observation here. You can see this is a data frame object, R object. So we have the subject, and we have a balance. It's the within subject factor, and we have the dependent variable recall here. So the model is going to be afex. Easy and subject and recall the data within balance, and we can print the model. So here we get an ANOVA table. We get the p-value, generalita squared, the mean square error, degrees of freedom, and so on. So you can see here it did some sphericity correction. So if you don't want it to do a sphericity correction, you can have a look at the afex documentation. I leave a link in the description below. So the next step, it is to continue with some follow-up analysis. We can do a pairwise comparisons between the different factors, the different levels of the factor balance, so negative, neutral, positive, and so on, and see if they are statistically significant. There's a difference in recall on all levels, between all levels. So we go into import emmeans, and we use R packages, import R and emmeans. And here, if we don't do a object translation here, we use this, if we don't have these parameters, translations, we're going to get an error and we can't use the package. So recover data cell call, and we need rename it to recover data call one. So the parameter is going to be a dictionary, and you can have many more if needed. So let's do the pairwise comparisons then. emmeans, and we have our model. And valence and contrast is going to be pairwise. And we do a Holmbond-Ferroni correction on the p-value. And then we can print the results. And here we go. So we can see here that we also get a confidence interval, standard deviation. Here we get the contrast, so negative neutral is statistically significant, and negative positive is, and neutral positive. So, and we see that the p-value was adjusted, or the p-values were adjusted using the Holm method. That was it. That was the Rpy2 example that I had in mind to do. You can also display graphics, but it's a bit more tricky, I would say. But I will return with a video just displaying basic R graphics in a Jupyter notebook. I hope you learned something, and if you did, make sure to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you don't miss anything. Leave a comment below if you have something you want to learn that I can upload to my channel. Bye!